Today we will be seeing about mangled extremity. Mangled extremity refers to an injury to an extremity that is so severe that the salvage is often questionable and amputation is a possible outcome. It is always caused by high energy trauma with some combination of crush, shear, blast and bending forces. Components are skin and soft tissue loss, fracture and bone loss, vascular injury, nerve injury. Skin and soft tissue loss will be very much extensive in mangled extremity. The fracture in the mangled extremity will be highly comminuted. It may be either associated with vascular injury or nerve injury. When three out of these four components is present, it is called as mangled extremity. The causes of the mangled extremities are blunt trauma, motor vehicle accidents, industrial and farm accidents, fall from height, high velocity gunshots, explosion injuries. Whenever this patient present to emergency ward, you have to examine the patient based on the ATLS protocol. You have to do thorough primary and secondary surgeries. You have to resuscitate the patient with IV fluids. If necessary, we can give blood transfusion. You have to give antibiotics as much as possible. As earlier, we administered the antibiotics, it will reduce the infection rate. The recommended antibiotics for mangled extremities are first generation cephalosporin and gentamicin. If wound is severely contaminated, we can give high dose penicillin. If the patient is allergic to penicillin, we can give metronidazole to prevent anaerobic infections. Tetanus immunoglobulin has to be given to prevent Clostridium tetanus infection. Then we have to remove cross contamination. Then we have to give wound wash. The recommended irrigant for wound wash is normal saline. For grade 1 Gustilo Anderson open fractures, we have to use 3 liters normal saline. For grade 2, 6 liters. For grade 3, it is 9 liters. Then we have to reduce the fracture and we have to splint it. We have to examine the distal neurovascular examination before and after reducing the fracture. Then we have to look for the signs of compartment syndrome. The incidence of compartment syndrome is around 10%. Since these mangled injuries are caused by high velocity injury, there will be extensive soft tissue edema and the facial planes are incompletely open. So this can result in compartment syndrome. Then we have to take the x-rays in two orthogonal view. Next important thing is we have to take a photo of the injured limb. Before taking the photo, we have to get consent from patient if possible. If patient is unconscious, you have to get the consent from legal representative. These photos can be used in future for wound comparison. After stabilizing the patient, we have to examine the injured limb. First, we have to examine the soft tissue. Look for the size of the laceration. And we have to assess for the skin loss and the muscle loss, whether the wound is contaminated or we have to clearly examine and we have to document in the case sheet. Then we have to assess for the vascular injury. We have to look for the odd and soft signs associated with vascular injury. Odd signs are the one which is obviously associated with vascular injury. They are pulsatile bleeding, rapidly expanding hematoma, palpable thrill, and audible fluid. Soft signs, these may or may not be associated with vascular injury. They are history of arterial bleeding, non-expanding hematoma, pulse deficit without ischemia. Whenever vascular injury is suspected, maxillary opening must be obtained. Then we have to assess both the sciatic and femoral nerve examination should be done and it has to be documented in the case sheet. After completing the examination of the injured limb, you have to decide whether the limb is salvageable or not. There are some classification and scoring system used in clinical decision making. The first we will be seeing about Gustilo Anderson scoring system. This is the first scoring system which is formulated for open fracture. Most of the mangled extremity falls into the Gustilo Anderson type 3B and type 3C fracture. What is type 3B Gustilo Anderson open fracture? These are the fracture with the extensive soft tissue injury with the periosteal stripping and the bone will be exposed with the major wound contamination. Type 3C is open fracture with arterial injury. The drawbacks in Gustilo Anderson classification is there was no guideline given for a treatment protocol, and it doesn't say about the functional outcome of the limb. Another disadvantage is grading will be changed in serial debridements. First, the wound will be type 3A, and after one debridement, it may become type 3B. There is underrepresentation of type 3B in Gustloff-Anderson scoring system. So other scoring systems were formed. First, you will be seeing about the Messi scoring system, mangled extremity syndrome index. It is formulated based on a retrospective study conducted on the 17 patients over 3-year period. When the score is less than 20, it is the limb is told to be salvageable. Second scoring system is predictive salvage index. When score is less than 6, limb is salvageable. If it is more than 6, amputation is advised. Then the MESS score was formed. It is formulated based on the retrospective study conducted on 26 patients. The components in MESS score are skeletal and soft tissue injury. When it is low energy injury, the score was given as 1, medium energy 2, high energy it is 3, very high energy it is 4. Second component, limb ischemia. When pulse is reduced but there is normal perfusion, score is 1. When pulse is absent with decreased capillary refill, score is 2. When the limb is cool, paralyzed, insensitive and numb, the score is 3. When the duration of the presentation is more than 6 hours, you have to double the scoring of ischemia. And the third component is shock. When systolic blood pressure is more than 90, score is 0. When it is transiently less than 90, it is 1. When it is persistently less than 90, score is 2. Last component is age. When less than 30 years, score is 0. 30 to 50, score is 1. More than 50, score is 2. If the total miss score is less than 6, limb is salvageable. 7 or more than 7, it is an indication for amputation. Then limb salvage index are formulated. When the scoring is less than 6, as per limb salvage index, it is salvageable. More than 6, it is an indication for amputation. In NISA scoring system, NISA scoring system is a modification of MESS score. In addition to the components of the MESS score, nerve injury is added in NISA scoring system, and soft tissue and skeletal components is separately placed in NISA scoring system. The limitations of the scoring system is the scoring systems are formulated based on the retrospective study rather than the prospective study. Most of the scoring system formulated with a small sample size. All this scoring system gives a considerable amount of weightage to the ischemia. In some clinical scenarios, it may lead to salvageable limb to amputation. For example, if you use MESS score in a 30-year-old male with high energy trauma to tibial fracture, with a normal perfusion, with a diminished pulse, secondary to spasm, with the persistent hypotension, secondary to splenic rupture, the score will come as 7. But we all know that this hypotension in this patient is due to splenic rupture. If you do laparotomy and splenectomy, the perfusion will become normal, BP will become normal. So we can't decide whether the limb is salvageable or not based on the scoring system. And another drawback of this scoring system is we are not able to predict the functional outcome based on the scoring system. To assess the clinical utility of this scoring system, LEAP study was conducted. LEAP study is a lower extremity assessment project in which all the scoring system was evaluated. The conclusion in LEAP study is it does not validate the clinical utility of the scoring system, but it showed that scoring system with high specificity used to predict the limb salvageability, but we can't use the scoring system for amputation. Ganga Hospital scoring system. It is mainly formulated to predict the salvageability of the type 3B injuries. The components in this Ganga Hospital scoring system are, the first component is skin and soft tissue. When the wound is not over the fracture and with no skin loss, the score is 1. wound is not over the fracture with skin loss score is 2. Wound over the fracture with no skin loss score is 3. Wound over the fracture with skin loss it is 4. The second component is muscular tenderness and nerve unit. When muscular tenderness unit is exposed with no injury, it is 1. Repairable injury to muscular tenderness unit it is 2. Irreparable injury to muscular tenderness units with repairable nerve injury is 4-3. Loss of one compartment of muscular tenderness unit with irreparable nerve injury is 4-4. Loss of two or more compartments, it is 5. The third component in the Ganga scoring system is skeletal injury. When the fracture is transverse or oblique, it is 1. When the butterfly fragment is present or unicortical combination, it is 2. When periarticular combination is present, the scoring is 3. When bone loss is less than 4 centimeter, scoring is 4. When it is more than 4, scoring is 5. Scoring also given for comorbid conditions. Open injury more than 12 hours. See a very contaminated wound, age more than 65 years, debilitating diseases such as diabetes mellitus, COPD, scoring also given for those diseases, fat embolism, associated systemic injuries, and other major injuries with the same limb or compartment syndrome. If the total score is less than 14, then limb is salvageable. If it is more than 17, it is an indication for amputation. Score 15 and 16 comes under gray zone. Based on the resources in the hospital, a surgeon can make the decision whether to go for amputation or salvage in the gray zone patients. The main difference between other scoring system and Ganga scoring is we can predict the amputation in Ganga scoring system, but we can't predict amputation in other scoring systems. These are the potential scenarios in mangled extremities. We can immediately amputate the limb, or we can successfully salvage the mangled extremities, or we can attempt the salvage with the early amputation, unsuccessful salvage with the late amputation. These are the possible outcomes in mangled extremities. When we have to consider a limb salvage, when young patients with anatomically intact sciatic or tibial nerve, moderate soft tissue loss, with the moderate bone loss, when presented within 6 hours after vascular compromise, we have to salvage the limb. Once we are planning for salvage the limb, we have to first do debridement. We have to do the debridement layer by layer. First, we have to excise all the devitalized skin until the fresh bleeding comes. Then we have to debride the subcutaneous tissue, fascia, and then muscle has to be assessed for viability based on its contractility, consistency, color, and capillary bleeding. And then we have to give thorough wound wash. Then skeletal stabilization has to be done. We have to, mostly we will be doing external fixation for mangled extremities. Whenever vascular injury is suspected, we have to take a TT angiogram, and the site of the lesion has to be identified. Immediately we have to do vascular repair. Whenever we are planning for vascular repair, we have to do fasciotomy too. Soft tissue coverage. Regarding soft tissue coverage, when the wound is clean, and skin loss and soft tissue loss is very much minimal, we can go for earlier reconstruction, that is within 72 hours. We can apply SST within 72 hours. If skin and soft tissue loss is more, we have to wait until the wound becomes clean and granulating. Then we can go for a flap cover. It usually takes minimum 2 weeks. Nerve injury can be managed by nerve repair. If nerve repair is not possible, we can go for tendon transfer and bracing aids. Hyperbaric oxygen therapy. In mangled extremities, there will be severe vasopressin secondary to injury. So there will be reduced oxygen supply to the peripheral zones of the injury. It can be prevented by giving hyperbaric oxygen therapy. There are some absolute indications for amputation. When there is complete disruption of posterior tibial nerve, crush injury with vascular compromise if it is more than 6 hours. Relative indications for amputations are whenever the patient's mangled extremity with the presence with polytrauma, severe ipsilateral foot trauma. These are the relative indications for amputation. management of mangled upper extremity is different from lower extremity, because we usually we try to salvage as much as possible in upper extremity, because the process is available for amputated lower limb is good, but in for upper extremity the processes are not good. The critical time for reperfusion is longer in upper extremities compared to lower extremities. In case of lower extremity, complete transection of the nerve is an indication for amputation, but not in case of upper extremities. Whenever we are planning for limb salvage, we have to counsel the patient regarding secondary amputation, sepsis, and significant social and economic burdens. There are some advantages of early amputation over salvaging. There will be decreased morbidity, fewer operations only needed, a shorter hospital course, decreased hospital cost, shorter rehabilitation, earlier return to work, treatment course and outcome are more predictable. Modern prosthetics often provide better function than the successfully salvaged limb. The decision to amputate or salvage severely injured limb is difficult one. The decision to reconstruct or amputate an extremity cannot be based on salvage course. Results of limb reconstruction are equal to those of amputation following severe lower extremity trauma. The correct decisions are based on the patient as a whole, not solely on the extent of the limb injury.